Back at the shop. So the next step in these doors is the hinges. Mounting the hinges to these doors. So these doors have a surface mounted hinge. This is the hinge, okay? Let me take you to the table. So sometimes you gotta get creative when you need to drill long things. So I shoved my drill press into that corner, made that, added a bunch of scraps there to bring it level with the drill press. Same thing over there on the table saw. So I got one continuous platform to put these doors on when I drill the T-nuts on the back, because that's important. What you want is a big surface, okay, to lay both of your doors down. You need to prop up the door so that the hinge drops down into this cavity here. Otherwise, it would not register right. And you need to lay all this out now, okay? It's important. Alright, so what I do is get the hinge positioned. I square up the bottoms of the doors to get them together. Set my hinge down, make sure it's proper. Then I take a piece of tape, go across both doors. So this is kind of like indexing my hinge for later, just to make sure that it lines. So I could just drop it right down and it'll line up and all's well. So I make a slice in the middle, make a slice here. So once I separate the doors and everything, it's together. I mark the tops of the hinges, okay, for the door. And now what I do is, this is a self-centering drill bit, right? So you're tempted to, these holes in the hinges here, the holes in the hinges are 1/4 inch. You're tempted to put 1/4 inch bolts in here, right? Don't. I went down to 10/32 or 10/24, something like that. This is what I put in there. All stainless hardware, 10/24 by 1 inch. Right. So it's important right now to line everything up, because on the other side of this door, you need to line this up. And one of the things on having the smaller bolt as opposed to a bolt that fits exactly in that hole is you have a little bit of wiggle room, so you can move your hinge around if you need to position it ever so slightly, because how you drill all these holes in the next processes is going to really dictate where this hinge and door is going to meet up. So you want to take your time. That's why you use something like this. It's going to register in that hole. You want to bring the hinge over to your shoulder and drill straight down. That's going to give me a pilot hole. Then I'm going to go over to the drill press and really drill through with all these holes, because they need to be exact or close to it. So, to me, the drill press is the best place, the best way to do all these holes, okay? If you don't have a drill press, they have drilling blocks that you can use. I'll show you one in a second or so. This is a drill block, okay? It's got steel inserts. It's common sizes, 8/3/16 quarter, okay? And it's got center marks on the edges and on the at each drill location, you can see there. This is the next best thing to use, because your holes need to be straight, okay? If they're not straight, they're not going to register. So what I do is, this is the, this would be the out, the face. Yeah, this would be the outside move. Hold on. So your hinge is registering here, okay? So what I do is, now I'll drill a potted hole all the way through with a 7/32 bit, because you need to locate, this is the back side, this is the other side. You need to locate this hole, so you need to locate this position so that I can use this fastener bit to make this, and that 7/32 bit would just leave a little poke hole for that point. And then I drill this, and then lastly I drill a 1/4 inch hole for that 10/24 for that smaller bolt, and that gives you a little bit of room in there to move this door around anywhere where you might need it to line that hinge up, so that its top and bottom is correct. So this is what would be, depending on the position of the door, either the inside of the door or the face of the door, you would see these T-nuts. And that's how Septa did it, just a different type of nut. I couldn't find the nuts that they use. These are all stainless again. And then you would drill that 1/4 inch hole to locate, to pass that nut through the other side. And because this barrel of this, this is the back side of a T-nut, so that diameter there is, outside diameter is 1/4 inch or a little less, right? So it gives you a little bit of room to move that hinge around by using a smaller nut and bolt, or T-nut and bolt. Don't be tempted to use a 1/4 inch bolt, okay? That's it. Hope that helps you do these part, this part of the doors. This is kind of like the final step of the doors, besides doing the windows. And the windows are pretty straightforward. This part is really important because you have all these other steps that you've done before this, and if you mess this up, you mess the door up. So yeah, be well, be safe.